channel, or if you're new here, welcome, my name is Ella. And for today's video, I thought let's make some blueberry jam. Now, I've never made blueberry jam before. I've made strawberry jam with my oma and mama before, or rather watched them make it. And I just taste tested it. But yeah, I thought, you know, it's right now blueberry season, and our grocery store, our local one, had a lot of blueberries on sale. They were really affordable, so I thought, you know, I'll pick up a couple of those buckets and make some of the blueberry jam that I've always wanted to try. So if you want to make blueberry jam, the first thing you're gonna need is blueberries. I took a lot. I took 800 grams of blueberries, and that's just because they were in those buckets. Make sure that all the berries are clean. If you are foraging your berries, make sure that you definitely have them nicely washed. And then all you really need to do is bring them in to a boil in a pot. So I essentially got this recipe online. I will link it below. But really what you're doing is you are putting them all together in a pot, and then you're mashing them up, at least most of the berries. It kind of depends on the consistency that you prefer, if you like more texture, or if you prefer, you know, it to be more smooth, then you can not mush them up too much. And once they're mashed up together, you add a little bit of water. It depends on the amount, of course, that you have of blueberries. I added a cup of water. Looking back, I probably would have added only half a cup of water instead. And then the secret ingredient is sugar. A lot of sugar. I prefer white sugar. You can get jelly sugar, like sugar that turns more into jelly-like consistency. I prefer just using regular sugar, to be honest with you. And yeah, so you bring that to a boil. It needs to be a hard boil, meaning if you stir it, the bubbles will remain, and you let that bubble for like a couple of minutes. Constantly stir it and make sure it doesn't bubble over or anything like that. And then after that has boiled for maybe like 5 minutes, then I let it simmer. Now the simmering process took the longest, almost an hour, because I had such a large amount of berries and jam, and I just constantly stirred it, and I just constantly made sure that, you know, the consistency is getting right. And it does take a while, but you'll get there eventually. And then what you do is, once it starts to really kind of get darker and get a harder consistency, you can put a little bit, well, obviously, you know, on your spoon you'll immediately notice, is it still very runny, or is it already kind of sticking to the spoon a bit? If it is starting to stick to your spoon, you can drop a little bit onto a plate and then put that in a freezer. And then after like 5 minutes, you can check on it, and if it makes wrinkles or ripples when you like touch it, the jam, then you know it's ready. I did this twice. The first time it was not ready yet, it was still too liquidy, so I kept just simmering it and stirring it. But yeah, if you just watch it closely, you'll probably manage. It's a relatively easy recipe. I've never made jam before. It worked out really nicely. It tastes delicious. And yeah, and blueberries just have really, really great properties. They're also very good for your health. They're antioxidant and very, very healthy. Now, a little bit about the history on the blueberry. Blueberry actually has been used for hundreds of years. It was really popular in the Middle Ages, especially if you had a cough or for stomach issues. The leaves oftentimes were also used for healing. So if you prepare the leaves or the green parts essentially of the plant, you could use it for a lot of different type of ailments, specifically more so for the stomach. And it was important to not overdose, because that could become poisonous. It's important to pick the berries when they're completely ripe, and then you can add them in tea, juice, tinctures, or even make wine out of them. Blueberries also are good for things like diarrhea. If you're experiencing diarrhea, especially diarrhea in combination with bloating, it's really good. In the form of a tea, usually. It also is said that blueberries are good for your eyesight. They have a lot of kind of vitamins and just things that are really, really good for your body overall. And they also help with menstrual pain. So if you have menstrual cramps, you can try blueberry tea or blueberry prepared kind of things like tinctures or, you know, this jam, for example, maybe even. And it's supposed to help. It also helps in general for bladder ailments. Now, in a more magical way, of course, we've already talked about the protection of it. But if you are feeling like you definitely need a little bit more magic or your household needs more magic, I feel like these blueberry jams are great for that because you're like ingesting it. It's going to just be inside of you. So if you want to also have it on your altar for protection for an offering. So for example, if you make pancakes in the morning, make one extra pancake that you can dedicate to the spirits, for example, of your home, or if you work with ancestors or any deities. And then I personally would be eating that pancake with the blueberry jam at the altar and let the spirits enjoy it through you so that it doesn't go to waste. This is from Scott Cunningham's Encyclopedia of Magical Herbs. We've got the blueberry, which is known for protection. And if you place some blueberries beneath the doormat to keep undesirables away from your property or from entering your home, this protects against evil as well. Make blueberry pies or tarts and eat when under psychic attack. This gets the protection inside you and increases the herb's effectiveness. So blueberries are very, very protective. I actually in my book have a blueberry pie recipe as well. So I'm actually just making the jam. I really like the protective property, especially the like protective home property with it. I feel like home protection is always just a very good measure to take. And of course, if you have been picking the blueberries, then I would suggest to keep the actual branch of the blueberry. Just pick the berries off and keep the branch and hang that and let it dry. And I just like hanging things on the walls. I always find that kind of is a really great way to add a little bit of extra protection as well. You can also work a lot of the leaves or the blueberry wood, you know, where it kind of grows on, into charms, for example. I can make a video on that in the future as well if you'd like. But yeah, that is the blueberry jam. So they definitely have a lot of different uses that you can try. I really just enjoy the flavor of blueberry. It's my favorite type of jam. I always gravitated towards it. So yeah, that's the blueberry jam. Now I'm probably going to be eating this on bread with some soft cheese, and that's my favorite way, or maybe with some pancakes. I'm also kind of, I don't know, I'm kind of thinking about shifting my content a little bit more and doing a little different content, including more folklore, recipes and things like that. And this is going to be the first one, so I'm really, really excited. I have the exact recipe on my Patreon, so if you would like to support me there, I will link that below. It, of course, helps me upkeep this channel and, you know, get new gear, like a new laptop that I just got, which was really exciting. But yeah, if you like this video, consider giving it a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll be seeing you soon. Bless be, bye! Thank you.